Ms. Price?
John.
Mr. Onstein back yet?
No, not yet.
Hi, Elian. Have you heard from Mr. Onstein? What time is he due?
I don't know. The lawyer said tonight.
Are you nervous?
Nervous, scared, excited, happy, you name it, I am it.
Too bad you got a show to do.
I thought I've got a show to do.
You're probably right.
So forth.
can just resign. I'm sorry, kiddo.
Yes, so am I. And so's Keating gonna be. What do you think, beautiful girls gonna stay in style forever? They should say not. Any minute now they'll be out, finished, and then it'll be my turn. My turn!
Yes, I did. When you went in, that was enough.
You know, Fan, if a girl ain't perfection,
better take up a collection.
Every girl must be a dazzler and a mute. You've got very nice deportment, but when they see that assortment, from the gallery they'll be throwing fruit.
Who is as black or as
give up. Man, it's 6 o'clock in the morning, and you know where we're getting? Nowhere. I felt so sorry for you, teenies. I talked myself into thinking that this could work. But you can't learn a number in one night.
Yes, I can. It's just a few simple steps. You said yourself I didn't even come with a song. And anyway, it's for your sake as well as mine. You bring me in tomorrow and I'm no good. Ooh, Kimmy will kill you. I'll even fire you.
So I don't bring you in. Then it won't matter that you're no good.
Oh, but I will be good. And anyway, you promise. Come on.
Okay. All right. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One, two, three, four. Oh, did you really play a 60-year-old Indian chief? Nothing. I just feel like sitting on a car.
Fanny!
What?
Fanny! Enough's enough. You haven't been to bed yet. What did you say his name was?
Eddie Ryan.
Well, Eddie Ryan, that's life for you. You got up yesterday morning, you felt good, everything was fine. And then you met my daughter, Fanny.
So you know, huh?
Who should know better? I live with it.
Fanny, please. I need some sleep.
Oh, okay, kid. Go home. Catch Woody Wakes. Relax.
Thank
Don't
you.
Worry about a thing. I'll see you, Peewees. Nice guy. But not much energy.
I noticed.
I'll tell you the truth. I don't think he has very much confidence in me.
Oh, don't let it bother you, darling. You've got enough for the two of you.
Mama.
We'll be right back.
matches, I still think my boy was better than yours. But as it was obviously in a non-aggressive mood.
Well, you didn't have to make a special trip down here. Your credit's good with me.
This is how it got me.
Boy, am I tired.
Not me. I can play the show all over again. On my hands and knees, maybe, but all over again. You want to see? Okay. Wait till Mr. Keeney sees this. I'm really going to get a terrific raise.
Good evening.
Gorgeous.
I beg your pardon.
Your shirt. It's absolutely the most gorgeous thing I ever saw in my whole life. What's it made of?
French handkerchief linen. Goes very lindly.
Yeah, I can see. All the same though, it's beautiful. All the other tailcoats I've met, rented. You know, real one. Stiff shirts.
Well, they should have. This is just a conversation piece.
Well, I never got past 3B, so I don't know what that means.
Just something to give people something to talk about. And you learned everything you needed to in 3B, Miss Price. You were wonderful, very excited.
Hey, you know my name?
Of course, I look for it in the program.
And you did think I was good. Excuse me. But are you someone I should know?
Oh, I think so. You mean, am I somebody that knows something about theater? No. But I'm supposed to have an eye for what's unique, special. And I think you're going to be a very big star one day.
Oh, thank you. You're the first person who ever said that to me. Who wasn't a relative.
I won't be the last.
Well, hey, Nick, I wanted to ask you, what's the word on this big Irish horse they're bringing over for the dirty, huh?
So lately? Yeah, I saw him running Dublin last spring. I wouldn't.
Then I won't.
So you got around thinking about me, yeah, Mr. King?
Oh, you're rich now. I'm willing to pay you $40 a week. Take it or
leave it. Leave it. I'm offering $65.
For what? Just one of your own show business.
I'm offering on behalf of one of your competitors, Mr. Keeney. $65 a week, Miss Price.
$75.
$85.
$90.
$100.
$110.
Oh, that wasn't entitled to go over $100. She's all yours, Keeney, at $110 a week. Congratulations.
Feeling pretty good, huh?
if I'd just gotten an A in my report card, which I never did.
Nicky Einstein, Nicky Einstein, what a beautiful, beautiful name.
Eddie, I don't know how to thank you.
I don't know. There must be a way. Like, what are you doing Saturday night after the show?
Nicky Einstein, Nicky Einstein, what a beautiful, beautiful fellow.
Saturday night?
Well, if it's just to sit around and schmooze, fine. If it's like a date, who's got time?
For that? Everybody.
Not me. Too busy.
Dressed in a full dress formal, and not even going to a wedding.
You know something? You're lucky.
Dames are a dime a dozen. A good friend is hard to find.
Oh, look, I'd appreciate to go out with a 60-year-old Indian chief. I'm not searching for a friendship.
Oh, I can't help it. It's what you found. I bet he knows who he found. He didn't even know Mr. Wrigley from Spearmint.
Look, every now and then I meet a guy who looks like you. Fatter, thinner, shorter, taller, but just like you. And the guy always turns out to be a friend.
That's the most heartening bit of news I've had in ages.
Nicky Einstein, Nicky Einstein, did you see how he had polish on his nails?
Come on. I'll take you home. We'll sit around and schmooze.
You take off your dress.
Greetings and salutations.
when I worry that my daughter Fanny is out of work, I'll send you a telegram. Like someone sent her a telegram.
Again, a stock company?
You want me to read it, or we're playing a game, and you want two more guesses? Dear Miss Bryce, please do me a big personal favor and come to the New York Theater on Thursday at 4 o'clock in regards to starring in the new Ziegfeld Follies. Love and kisses, signed Florence Ziegfeld. you want to make yourself useful? Go help Fanny get into the dress. Some of those scenes I wouldn't guarantee.
Fanny, darling, tell me everything!
Well, Eddie, the Ziegfeld Follies, now she belongs to the ages. My work is done. My work is done.
Our work is done. She doesn't need us. She'll have cake. We'll have drums. Be careful of the stage door. Here she comes.
Miss Bryce, that's exactly what I mean. If I take you out of the finale, I will also take you out of Cornet Man and the Follies. I give the orders and make the decisions here, not you. That's your opinion.
Well, whose opinion should I have? Diamond Jim Brophy's?
Brady.
That's your opinion.
She's pulling ahead, Mrs. Ziegfeld.
Oh, Mrs. Ziegfeld?
Yes, Miss Price.
Listen, can I hum it?
You will say the words exactly as written, and that ends this discussion.
Yes, Mrs. Ziegfeld. Whatever you say.
Back to me, this one. springtime bride is starry-eyed, poets often say. No other bride would dare to dream the dreams that April and May.
Come soon, don't dawdle. Everybody, 24 Henry Street!
Yes, I did. You were right, Father. I give you my word of honor. If you ever flog my authority again, I'll ring the curtain down on you.
Listen, Mrs. Ziegfeld, I'm sorry if I spoiled your opening night, but if I was right, then you should listen to me. So I think that you owe me an apology, too. Okay. I'm Ella Hewell. I'll even go first. I'm not proud. Mrs. Ziegfeld, I apologize. And I mean it.
In that case, Miss Bryce, I apologize. And I thought you were wonderful.
Honest?
I'll prove it. I'm going to choose another song for you.
Oh, thank you. Oh, but listen, if there's one thing I feel really definite about, it's choosing my own songs.
Choosing your own
what? Songs.
Hey, congratulations, Philip.
Oh, it's you again.
You remember me?
Well, you were my first ruffled shirt. And my first $110 a week. Any competitors this time? Better offers?
Ziegfeld has no competitors.
Good to see you, Nick. How are they running?
Ahead, just like you and this little girl there. I discovered her before you did, Flo, and I had a hunch you'd belong together.
I have the same hunch. And it's aging me fast.
I knew it. I was sure that it was you who told him about me.
Oh, afraid not. I wish I had.
I don't believe you.
Well, should we call him back? You can ask him.
You probably fixed it up that way in between you.
Well, there's a point at which humility becomes ridiculous, so have it your own way. I'm your benefactor, and as your benefactor, I have a right to be very proud of you.
I did pretty well, huh?
That was no surprise to me. After all, I wrote the card with your flowers before the curtain went up. The white roses.
I didn't even have time to look. Dear star, I told you so.
If you were a horse, I would have bet on you.
Horses you bet on always win?
No. But they're always the best on the track. You were on your way before, and now you're here. The only question is, what do we do about it?
Something has to be done?
Oh, certainly. Success is something to enjoy, to flaunt, otherwise why work so hard to get it? Let's make grand entrances all over town, and watch people stare and whisper, that's Ziegfeld's new star. Who's the lucky man? Don't you see? I'm honored to see me sing with you. With you on my arm, to wear you like a charm. You're glitter decorating my arm. Now, naturally, such proximity gives rumors to rise. We'll let them analyze what our amalgamation implies. Oh, yes, the gossips will press, too eager to stress the seamy side. No, so what? I wanna be seen with you on my arm. Let's give this town a light and hit it like a meteorite tonight. I wanna be seen with you.
I can't. I have to meet a gang of people
at
my mother's saloon. Honest, it's a party. For me. Wanna come?
Oh, I'd love to.
Do you mean it?
Of course.
Maybe you better think it over.
Why, you thinking you're changing your mind?
No, look, I know it isn't every night that a glorified single girl like me asks you out, but this is just a neighborhood thing, and it might waste the evening for you.
Well, I'll be with you, won't I?
The moon, another mother's moon, have a nice back of room.
Get ready. start.
Hey, Danny! I've always wanted to waltz with a Ziegfeld star!
Yeah.
Say something.
Patty, would you say you're a woman of wide experience?
About what?
Men?
Oh, sure, I've known a million guys. After all, I'm not 10 years old, and I am in the theater, you know. Nah, I've been too busy. What about you? Hundreds of girls, huh?
The count is in the mere dozens. Nothing serious. And I like to feel free.
You get lonesome being that free?
You can get lonesome being that busy.
Who would think? Look at us. We have the same problem. We travel single. Show up sometime. You backstage 1 o'clock. hope she ain't making a mistake. You know who turned up in Baltimore and asked her out to dinner?
Who?
The ruffled shirt.
No! Oh, that lovely Mr. Arnstein. I knew she'd see him again. At the black block party, I put an idea in their heads. I planted a little seed.
You planted a seed on Henry Street, and 10 months later, a tree grows in Baltimore.
Ladies, I bet 3 cents.
And I raise you 3 cents.
Oh, I'm out.
Save your money, Rose. I raise you 3 cents.
And I'm calling you. What do you got?
A king of hearts, a 10 of diamonds, a 6 of clubs, a 4 of spades, and a 3 of diamonds.
Oh. Tag it. I thought you were bluffing.
Some way, but what did you expect?
that you could just come waltz into my life after 10 months, say, I have a week before I go to Europe, and have me fall into your arms?
Why did you just answer the question? Why are you angry?
I'm not angry. Why don't you answer the question? You think I should be quiet because this time your train isn't leaving tomorrow morning? This time you have a whole week to kill. Well, I'm not a kid at Keeney's anymore. You are not slumming anymore.
I never was, and you know it.
Don't holler at me.
I'm not hollering you.
That's different. I'm a natural holler. And anyway, I answered your silly question.
No, you didn't, my love. Because you got angry the first moment you saw me, before I said a word. And that surprised me. Because I lit up like a Christmas tree when I heard you were here.
Oh, just at the thought of great, big, wonderful me, huh?
Don't make fun of yourself, Fanny. It was at the thought of you. And I didn't think of it as a week to kill. I thought of it as a week to share.
Why didn't you show up at my last two open nights?
I was there.
Why didn't you come backstage?
Because you scare me to death. I meet a lot of people all the time. And I forget them just as quickly as I meet them. But I can't seem to forget you.
Maybe we should, order now.
Certainly. If you're sure you want to stay.
I might as well have dinner.
Very sensible. Paul, I think we're ready.
Caviar to start with, Mr. Onstein?
No, a puffy Strasbourg, I think. And a filet de bouffe, sauce poured legs. Stem strawberries and a very light Bordeaux with the filet de bouffe.
Serve me on 1905.
Perfect.
Thank you, Mr. Augustine.
All right.
I just ordered roast beef and potatoes.
I did. What's the matter?
Boy, if I get down and you order roast beef and potatoes, how will I know if you're making advances?
You'll know. I'll be much more direct. You. I am.
Don't complain. It's Baltimore we're leaving.
Damn it. I know I've forgotten something.
John, why can't we go home for a few days?
Because we're putting in new numbers in Chicago. That's why you can't go home. Now listen, everyone settle down and get on the train.
John, can you think of anything I've forgotten?
Where's your wife?
Oh, my God! Oh, will you watch yourself, stupid? Oh, my God.
It's drawing room B, Mr. Ziegfeld.
Emma!
Daddy! Uncle's here! New York face!
Hey, ladies, how are you?
What are you doing here?
Oh, I thought I'd surprise Fanny. Ride part of the way with her. She on the train yet?
Not yet. She went for a little walk. John, do you take care of Miss Bryce's luggage?
You mean that moth-eaten collection of cardboard boxes she had?
Oof, monogrammed yet.
She bought them yesterday.
Miss Fanny Bryce?
Oh, I'll take that.
Miss Bryce drinks champagne now?
Well, times change.
I'll see you on the train, Eddie. Come on, Quinn.
Morning walks, monogrammed luggage, champagne. How long's Nick Arnstein been around?
It was supposed to be a week, but he ended up staying through the run.
He isn't going to Chicago with us, though. He's going to New York and Europe, so there's nothing to worry about.
Who's worried?
I am. I'm always nagging her. Go out, have some fun. So in Baltimore, she went out and had some fun.
Well, let's go drink to our health in his champagne. That's called Ryan's Revenge. Come on, ladies.
Oh, come on, girls. You don't want to get stuck in Baltimore, do you?
Baltimore?
John, help!
Hey, Fan. What'd you do, go buy a pack of Baltimore?
Oh, I wish I'd bought the whole thing. It's the most beautiful city in the world. Be a sport. Forget your lost your ruffled shirt on that race. Come beautify Chicago with me.
Train for New York, track 8, go.
That's mine. You're going to have to improve Chicago by yourself.
It doesn't bother you that Monte Carlo won't have me in Chicago, will?
Of course it will bother me. For the 100th time, Monte Carlo has a deal waiting for me in Chicago, hasn't it?
There must be a law about you. You can't just walk in and change my whole life and walk right out of it.
I'll walk right back in. Fortune in each hand, just as fast as I can.
Yeah, another definite date, huh? Like last time.
Not a bit like last time.
Oh, what's different?
I love you.
Do you mean it? You're not just trying to be polite. Well, Nick, I'm a good friend of yours, and in a dumb way, I'm kind of smart, so I'm going to tell you what you ought to do. You ought to marry me.
Fanny.
You don't have to. I'm all yours anyway, and the kind of wife I'd make you wouldn't believe. Just look at my past record, huh? No errors, no strikeouts, nothing. That means no bad habits. I'd be learning the pot fresh, your way. And besides that, I'm lucky, and I'd be lucky for you. What could be better for a gambler than a lucky wife, huh?
We'll talk about it when I get back loaded with money.
Let's talk about it now.
Fanny, listen. I do want to marry you, but not when I'm broke. I want to be the head of the household, so no one can say that I married you because you're rich and famous. You're a big, strong girl, often used to getting what you want, but this we do my way or not at all.
Yes, Mr. Arnstein. Whatever you say.
Please remember.
Last call. Train for New York. Good.
I love you. And I'll be back.
John, get my luggage off that train.
What?
Get my luggage off that train. I'm not going to Chicago. Yes, when is the next train to New York?
One just left. There'll be another one in 15 minutes.
Oh, one ticket, please. How much is it?
5:23.
Fanny!
Oh, for Pete's sake, where did
you... Where do you think you're going?
To Monte Carlo with Nick Arnstein. Porter, Porter, get those bags off the train for me, Emma.
Do you know what you're doing?
Look, it took him 10 months to get back from Kentucky. If I wait for him to get back from Monte Carlo, I'll be an old lady.
Did he ask you to go with him?
No, but he'll be glad.
Are you out of your mind? Haven't you any pride?
I guess not. I love the guy, he loves me. I don't want to be with him. It's just that simple.
How do you know he loves you?
Because he told me. That's how I know. Why? Is it so impossible?
Oh, of course not, honey. Only... Well, you don't know one damn thing about him. Except for the fact that he's good looking, he wears fancy clothes, he talks big, and he struts around as if he owns the world. And if you don't think that can't be an act, then you're crazy.
Fanny! Have you forgotten you're going on tour with the show?
I never signed a contract, Paul.
You know I'm counting on you.
But the tour doesn't depend on me. You have 5 other top names, a week in Chicago to make adjustments.
You are being completely selfish, completely ungrateful, completely...
Well, be simmer down, but you'd also start flaring up.
That's funny coming from you. You gave me this ulcer.
Oh, my God. Well, listen. I love God. I love God. Onslaught, but you can't take an audience home with you. I want a personal life, too, and I'm gonna harm.
This is inconceivable. It's unprofessional. As for Mid-Arm, Gene, you want my opinion of him?
I don't. I'm going, and there isn't a single thing you can do about
it. And if you do this, I'm through with you. And I mean it.
You mean it now. You mean it later, I'll be sorry.
Ben, can't you see you're making a fool out of yourself?
No, I only know one way to operate. If something's right for me, I do it. And this is right for me.
But is it right for you?
I'll make it right for you.
Take my advice. Don't.
Don't. Tell me don't. Don't tell me not to live just silly pie. Life's candy and the sun's a ball of money. Don't bring a rubber cloud to leave it mine.
Yes, sir.
Wait, Mrs. Arnstein, this is Long Island, and there's a cottage there by the stables.
Come on, honey, it has to be a hotel, but I got all that grass on those trees.
All yours. How do you like it?
I love it. All I can say is, boy, when you marry somebody, you do it right.
You mean when somebody marries me, I do it right?
Aren't you ever going to forget that?
I like to remember. It makes me feel wanted.
Fine. Fair exchange. You feel wanted, and I'm the married lady. With trees. Only out, honey? What is a place like this rent for? Tell me by the day so we'll sell less.
I don't know. I didn't rent it. I bought it.
Nick!
With my winnings from Epsom Downs. Found money, that's called.
Nick, you know something? You are really crazy. I mean, a place like this for just two people?
How many people?
Excuse me? 2.5 people?
Might be a very large baby. A place like this tells people that the people who live here are on top of the world.
Well, I'm on top of the world. You're floating 10 feet above it.
Well, we could have done with a couple fewer rooms, but we would have had to move once the oil well starts producing.
Whose oil well?
Our oil well.
When does our oil well start producing?
Just as soon as we dig it. You mustn't be impatient, darling. We can be quite cozy here while we're waiting.
Cozy?
Cozy?
I'm the married lady with trees. And an echo.
Echo!
Yoo-hoo!
Yoo-hoo!
Betty loves Nicky!
So am I now!
Nick, how did you arrange this production from across an ocean?
I went to a first-class producer and I gave him free hats.
Free hats? Just look at these. Instructions.
Well, I thought you were through with me.
I would have been, except I know you're going to be in my new show.
With his new dance director.
His new dance? Hey! Well, I'm afraid I'll have to catch up with you on the next one. It's just that, making grandchildren for Mrs. B seem much more important.
You did it for me?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Benny, say something in European.
Hey, what'd you like best over there?
What I like best over here, Nick. You wouldn't believe the people he knows. Counts, princes, dukes.
No peasants.
Just me. Hey, Betty. Now that you're a married woman, better you should know a good butcher than a duke. And there, my married daughter Sadie can help you out.
Excuse me, darling. I've got to give my other girl a tour of the grounds. Ladies and gentlemen, the grand tour starts now.
I gotta see. For when people ask. Danny, get in touch with Sadie.
I will.
Tell me, what's it like being married, Fanny?
Fanny? I'm not Fanny. I got Natty. I'm Sadie. Everybody that gets married becomes a Sadie. I'm Sadie.
my daughter on the express. No transfers, no stops. Fanny's fine.
She starts rehearsals with me tomorrow on a new show.
You know, Fanny said she wasn't going to go back to work until little Francis, the baby, God bless her, was 1 year of age, and she's only 5 months. So I was wondering.
So what's such a big mystery? Fanny has wonderful help in the house, a lovely nurse for the baby, and nothing to do with herself all day. Why shouldn't she go back to work?
Well, I'd like to have it in the bank, but your son-in-law must have dropped in the oil well business.
Why should you have it in the bank? Better he should have it.
Rose, I wanted to ask you if...
Oh, it's all right. You can talk in front of Mrs. Graybatch. What she don't know, she'll find out.
Are they okay, Fanny and Nick? That oil well thing didn't hit them too hard?
They're fine. And Fanny tells me he's interested in something else.
Ah, a horse named Boo.
Horses don't interest him anymore. He's reformed.
Oh, like our rabbi.
I don't have to worry about them anymore.
Rosa, Mrs. Strayhosh and I have decided what you need is a new interest in life.
What are you talking about?
You need something to help keep you young.
Oh, I don't want to be young. I did that already. I still have the saloon.
The saloon closes up at night.
Everything closes up at night.
Not my Dave.
You're making me an offer?
Dave is mine. Listen.
Rose, find yourself a man.
You're demented.
Find yourself a man.
Just what I need.
You'll see what a difference it makes every day. Dave is still her slave.
Set the slave mind with all.
Open your heart and look out at the skies. A prince on a horse will materialize.
Boy, it's some lucky prince gonna get a surprise.
Find a man. Find yourself a man.
I repeat it, Rose.
Find myself a man.
Oh, you're defeated, Rose.
I'll hang a sign out big waters that I come in and say.
The house.
Exactly. I'm going to build the world's most beautiful gambling casino. I'm buying up half a floor.
have it downstairs, young fella, in the pocketbook. It's gonna take a lot of money. Come on, girls, time to get measured for your costumes. Let's go, girls!
My only financial problem is keeping the wrong money out. I want to keep this small, though. Maybe just a few close friends, like you.
It does sound like a good idea, Nick, but all my available cash is tied up in the show.
You don't want to miss this one, Flo. I'm gonna make a million.
Perhaps I can come in on the next one.
This is the big one.
Hey, could you two tycoons discuss this some other time on account of I need a wait with my husband?
Of course, dear.
Listen, why would Flo do you any favors? Why not?
It wouldn't be a favor, Fan. It's a good deal.
Oh, I know, I know. All I meant was, why not let me have a piece of it?
I don't want to use your money, brother.
Listen, we better get something straight. If this is a marriage, then what's yours is mine, and what's mine is yours. Otherwise, it isn't a marriage, and I'm just a kept woman. Well, if I'm going to be a kept woman, you're not rich enough. I can do better. So make up your mind. Is it a marriage or not?
It's a marriage.
Then I can't do better. How much do you need in it?
For the options on the land, $68,000.
Oh, what a divorce! 68! Woo! But I have it. My partner?
Some crowds took a drop. America! she said, like a chance, and blows in the air, but the terror's on the deep. When the fighting came before the magazine, tonight.
Nick, I was just trying to-
I don't want you! Need it!
sneaking around. I did all right before I met you. I can do all right again.
I don't need you to put 20,000 into me to make me look good. I can do that for myself.
Almost time to go to Carson.
Go on, Fanny, we're late for the theater. It's all right, forget it. Tom Blackton. Blackton, Nick Armstrong. Still peddling that fancy bond deal? So I'm in a listening mood. I don't care how risky it is, as long as it's profitable. I need $68,000 up front. If I can get $68,000, then you got me. Fine, I'll meet you.
Call me, Carla. Bye, Eddie. Eddie, a lawyer, Fallon.
months. With luck. Fanny, do you want to cancel the performance tonight?
No spiel about how the show must go on?
It's going to be all over the papers by this evening.
Well, they won't tell the truth. They won't say Nick Arnstein was an honest man till he married Fanny Bryce. Anyway, better get used to the publicity. It'll be all over the papers every time I go to visit Nick in prison.
Too bad you didn't think about that before he did this to you.
Oh, honey, you don't know what Nick did for me. Go away, kid, huh?
It's a big day here, isn't it?
Well, any day a fella comes home from prison after
8 months isn't exactly small.
Tiger?
Don't ask.
You haven't been up to see him in some time, have you?
I did it first, but he didn't really want me to. And he's the boss. He wrote often, though. Nice letters. Cheerful. Interesting.
Have you heard from him today?
No, not yet.
15 minutes, please.
Oh, I better let you get ready.
Oh, one other thing, Flo. I wasn't kidding about Nick being the boss. I love the guy. It's gonna be his way from now on, and I'm gonna be doing a lot of things differently. And that means giving up the theater. I hope you'll be a sport about it.
Well, I won't be. But I'm not gonna worry about it till I get your notice. Be happy, dear.
You ready for these? Get your props.
15 minutes, Miss Price.
Thank you, John. Nobody would have ever gotten me that. And you made me feel sort of beautiful. You know?
You're not sort of beautiful. You are.
Thank you.
Overture! Places, please!
Well, there are a lot of people out there waiting for me. Goodbye, Nick.
Bye, Fanny.
Steam again.
Yamsky. I'll never see him again.
On stage, Miss Bryce.